Hey, what's up? I'm Al Cox. I play games, make games, and everything in between. And the free version is finally out for Buildbox, so I'm gonna go through what that means for you, some of the details that are hidden in the pricing plan of what does free really mean, how to get started making games, how to keep you cool when Buildbox crashes on you. So let's go ahead and get started. Before I begin, if you're new to Buildbox, be sure to like and subscribe. Check out my review of when I started using Buildbox 3 and was just trying to learn the ropes of how things work. And this is a no-code software, so you can make a full and complete game without using any coding. And if you do know JavaScript, then you can code even more and do greater and better things. Let's jump into the pricing plan of Buildbox 3. $0 a month, or you can get the pro plan for $60 a month. Annually, that is $500 a year. Honestly, the free plan is the way to go. Now, I'm gonna go into a little bit more detail because free can mean a lot of things to a lot of people. Buildbox doesn't go into depth of explaining exactly how is it free. They're the catch. Starting out, we can see that the free version, you only get one world, whereas in the pro version, you get unlimited. Now, this isn't a big game changer. Honestly, you really only need one world. You can make unlimited scenes. The ability to have multiple worlds is very convenient because you can just copy and paste one world or five worlds and make that exact same world. Unfortunately, you cannot do that in the free version, but you can have unlimited scene, so it's a little bit constraining, but nothing that's going to stop you from making a cool game. Big thing here is that you get unlimited scenes. You can have 99 scenes all in one world. How you set that up is going to be determined on the game, but it's doable. Next, mobile export. Of course, you want to be able to put it onto your phone, whether it's iOS or Android, and this is free, so that's amazing. Next, we have desktop export. If you're gonna make a game for the PC or laptop, then you definitely want desktop export. I've been using Buildbox for about 3 years and I've never exported to a desktop. And at the same time, I'm only making mobile games. So this depends on you and what your goals are. Not even needed unless this is something you know from the very beginning that you wanna make desktop type of games. Next we have easy AdMob integration, easy Iron Source integration. Now this is brand new. This was not out in the previous version of Buildbox. I know because I was trying to implement ads and it was a pain in the ass. And at the end, I wasn't able to get it to work. However, with the new update, if you're on the free version, you don't have to do anything. AdMob is already integrated into the software. Buildbox gets a 10% cut, which if this is a big deal for you, then obviously do not sign up for the free program. When it comes to ad monetization in games, it's usually so minimal that it's not that big of a deal. And then if you end up making a good amount of money, you can just go ahead and buy the pro version and upgrade it. Buildbox will have all the ad integration set up for you in the free version of the software. You don't have to do anything and ads will already display. And if you make money, then Buildbox will send you a check at the end of the month. I think this is a very important piece to touch on because a lot of people who get into mobile game development expect just be getting paid a big check, but the hardest part of developing a mobile game is marketing that game out to people and having thousands of people to download it, showing ads, then making money. However, if this is not the case, you'll be likely to just only make a few dollars a month. And as you can see in the pro version, you can do other ad networks and in-app purchases. So I could see where in-app purchases would be something you would want. However, if you were new to Buildbox, you were just getting started, you have a lot to learn before you need to even be trying to make money in the software. I've been using Buildbox 3 every day for the last 6 months. Learning Buildbox is a process. We all learn at different rates, at different speeds. When I was first starting out in Buildbox 3, I would go to the Space Buggy template. So here you can see the characters moving left to right. But then when you tap over here, the character jumps over. It took me 4 hours to figure out how to adjust the movement node to get the character to move the way I like it. That's a 4 hour processing time of trying to figure out what is working, what is not working. 6 months later, I am able to create this space game and control the character to move in a 360 environment. And this took only a couple of minutes to recreate. And when you start out in Buildbox, there's a lot going on. You have a bunch of different nodes that tell you how you can move the character, interact with the world. If you are creating a game in either a 2D or a 3D environment, there is a lot of moving pieces and it will take time to learn. Buildbox has come out with more videos. I strongly recommend you check out all the videos on YouTube. And there's a lot of different channels. You can check out my channels. I have a lot of videos where I go through the development process of trying to learn and figure out Buildbox and just basic game dev logs of just getting more familiar with the software, because at the end of the day, that's what you're gonna wanna do. You're gonna wanna get familiar with it. You're gonna wanna try to spend as many hours as possible, both watching videos, playtesting, saving, trying new things out. A difficult part with Buildbox is that sometimes you don't know if you're making a mistake or if Buildbox has a bug. It requires a lot of trial and error. The great thing about Buildbox 3 is that it is a no-code software. You don't need to know how to code. Now, if you do know how to code, specifically in JavaScript, then you could potentially be unstoppable in terms of what you can do and create within Buildbox. Overall, I believe Buildbox does have a steep learning curve in that it takes time, maybe even months, to figure out exactly how to create things in the way that you want them to happen. My recommendation is to just keep things simple. If you have a game idea, make it very simple, put it on your phone, have other people play it. But get something out there. Don't get stuck in trying to make the perfect game. This is where I see a lot of people freeze themselves into always trying to make something a little bit better, a little bit more perfect. And I understand that. All the games I've ever completed, I always felt like I could have put in another 1, 2, 3 more months just making that game perfect. However, if you do that, then you'll never finish a game. Keep things simple, finish a game, get a good game mechanic that you like, good art that you like, and complete a game. Have your friends play it, get their criticisms, compliments, and then go ahead and make another game. If you're just trying to make one hit game, then that's fine, but I would recommend make a bunch of simple games and get more familiar with the software, because once you're familiar with the software, you can create different types of levels, gameplays, mechanics, and just do a bunch of new things that you have learned while playing with the software. So I hope this was helpful. If you're new to Buildbox, leave a comment. Let me know your frustrations, your accomplishments. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I will see you next time. Peace.